Good morning, creativity class, and welcome to Arts and Crafts with Miss Elizabeth. So this time we will be making a bee craft, which is super cute, because this week's theme is obviously spring and summer, winter, fall, all the seasons that Miss Lorraine and Miss Marie are going over with you. This week we're going to specifically go over spring and summer because that's kind of right around the time that we are. So this time I'm going to do a spring activity, which will be our bee activity because we have lots of bees coming out with the flowers now blooming. And then the next time for this week that you'll be doing my craft, it will be a summer kind of themed craft. Okay, so we're going to get started on our bee craft. What you will need is this template that I sent. You won't need this, but you will need this, and this, and then this, which I've sent you all of this. Or I've sent Miss Marie and Miss Lorraine all of this. So try to see if Mom and Daddy can print this out for you before we start doing the craft. And then you will need a toilet paper roll. You will need glue. We can use either school glue or a glue stick. You will need scissors. And then we will need colored paper. So we will need a piece of yellow paper and then a piece of black paper. And if you don't have construction paper that's colorful like this, you can always use a piece of white paper and just cut these out just like I'll show you how to do, and you can trace it on other white paper and color it in with like crayons or colored markers. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. So first we want to cut out these little stencils. So I'm going to cut out the circle first. We want to cut around it to make it easier for ourselves. So we have a little tiny piece to cut. And we'll cut around. This circle. I'm trying to cut off most of this marker because I kind of want it to be just white. So there's less of this color. So I'm going to turn it over here because for this, I'm actually going to color in using a lovely crayon, which is something else that I forgot to mention, but you will need a crayon. Something like a tan or a brown crayon because it's going to be the head of the bee. So we'll cut this out and then we're going to color this, just this piece that we'll cut out. But for these other stencils, we will need to trace them. Actually, okay, I'm gonna scratch all that. Okay, so for this round piece that we just cut out, this is going to be the head of our bee. So it's gonna go right here. And we're going to color this one with some crayons that we'll need. So we'll need like a brown or a tan crayon so it can be the head of the bee. And this is, we're going to actually use this from the piece of paper that we cut out. But for this one, we will need to trace that on the black paper that we have. And then for this one, we're going to use this specific thing that we're cutting out to put on here. So it's just this piece that we'll need to trace with. Okay, now I'm going to cut out this. And because it's on the edge, I don't need to cut it out of, cut out a little piece of it like what we did for the circle because it's right on the edge, so it's pretty easy. Okay, now we'll cut out this one. This one I am going to cut around it. go. Gonna move these scraps. You can take your time with this one because it is kind of a tricky shape. So we can definitely take our time. Oopsie. Make sure to turn the paper with the scissors, just like we worked on in the other videos. And if this takes longer for you to cut out than it is taking me on this video, that's okay. You can just pause the video until you catch up to the next part. Me finish cutting and then we can start the next part together. Okay, there we go. Now we have our wings. Alrighty, so for the yellow, we want to start with the yellow paper. So this yellow paper, we want to take our toilet paper roll, which it's alright if it has the last bit of the toilet paper on it, because it's kind of hard to take off because it's pretty glued on there. So, and we're going to cover it with paper anyway, so it doesn't really matter. But what we want to do is we want to take our piece of paper, just like we did with the binocular arts and craft. We'll take a marker or a pencil, pen, anything. We want to put the toilet paper on the edge of the paper. And try to use it the long way, not this way. Okay, so we'll put it on the edge, and then right where it is above is where we want to put a little mark. Just so we know. Okay, now we want to put our toilet paper roll back on the paper. And we'll pick up the edge and we'll roll it over. So then we know exactly how much paper we need to cover the toilet paper roll. So we'll go all the way over. And that is where we will stop. So we want to take the pen off of, cap off the pen. We'll put a little mark right where it stops. All right. So once we have that, it might actually be nice to use a piece of paper if you have one. So I have this edge of paper. Or a ruler, if you have anything to use to help you draw a straight line, then that would be great. So what we want to do is we have our two dots. So we have one dot here, you can kind of see it right there, and then we have one dot right here. So we want to try to connect the dots into a shape. And this shape will probably look like a rectangle or maybe even a square. Because we have the two lines coming. It's all straight lines. And there's four lines connecting it. So what we want to do is we want to put this paper, ruler, whatever we have, in a straight line touching one of the dots. And then we can kind of use that to guess right around where it would match. So actually we'll start by drawing half of this line. So we'll go up halfway. Okay. Now on this side, we'll put this over here. And we'll put it in a straight line. And then we're going to draw halfway. So now we have this. And now we can kind of guess right where it's going to match in the middle. We want them to meet right here. So we can kind of put a dot there. And then that'll make it easier for us to draw a line going all the way up to that dot. And then we'll do another one on this side. We can draw another line. There we go. So now we have the size of the toilet paper roll on the yellow paper. We can go ahead and cut this out. So we can just cut on the lines. There we go. And now we have our yellow piece. Okay, once we have that, then we want to take our stencil that looks like this, and we want to draw three of these on the black paper, or we want to trace three. So we'll use a marker, and we'll put this down, hold it with our fingers. Oops, we can go slower. There we go, now we'll shift over. There we go, there's one. We'll do a second one. I'm going to try to keep them as close as I can, because I don't want to waste a lot of paper. And because it is Earth Month, and last week was Earth Week, that's why we did all those activities with recycled materials, and we learned about the Earth. And because it's Earth Month, we're using more recycled materials. But with that being said, paper is made from trees. So trees are on the earth, and we want to be good to our friends, the trees, because they give us oxygen, they wave hello in the wind, and they smile at us when it's sunny and shines. So because of that, we want to be nice to trees and use as little paper as we can. Around. And then move our fingers. Oopsies. And then we'll go all the way around. Okay, so now that we have our three bumblebee stripes, we'll cut this out. We'll go ahead and cut this piece out to make it easier for us. Okay, and then once we have this piece cut out, then I'm actually going to cut in between them to separate them, because then that will make it easier to cut them all out. And then they're all their own piece, and we can cut them out. Okay. Here's one. Start the second one. Here's the second. And then we'll cut the last one. Okie dokie. Now we have 1, 2, 3. I can put this paper away. Put these scissors away. So I'm going to take the head now. And I'm going to color that guy. Let's see. I'll color his head brown. This one's kind of tricky because it's a really small piece, so it can kind of tear the paper easily or scrunch it like this. So you want to try to take your time and hold it down because we don't want to rip this little guy. We don't want to rip his head. That would be silly. Okay, now we have his head. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take a black color. Let's see if I can, oh, that is right here. Okay, we're going to take a black crayon. And we can draw. Oops, crayon just broke. Holding it too hard, we can draw a little smiley face for our bumblebee. Okay, so we can put that aside. So now we're going to use our tape. We'll take a piece off, and we want to put this on. Our side of paper. And we want to pull it up like this. So it looks like this. We can put our tape down. So we'll put it on one side. We can use a little bit more tape because we really want it to stick on there. There we go. And then we roll it all the way around until it goes all the way over. And it covers our other side. You can kind of pull it tightly so it rolls over. And then we want two more pieces of tape. Whoops. Actually, this will be one piece of tape. This is very long. Sometimes it doesn't rip. There we go. Okay, so we'll use this one piece of tape. Goes all the way. Oh, this is a very long piece of tape. Okay, I can kind of wrap this around in the inside because it's too long. And I'll pull that all the way down. Rub it over. And now our bee is yellow. So now what we want to do is we want to take our stripes. I'm going to put these little guys on here. And so to do that, we can use our tape. Okay, and what we want to do for the tape is we want to keep the tape all on this back side where this tape is because that's where we're going to put these wings. So then you can't really see the tape. Okay, so this guy we'll put on here, right at the bottom, because that's where our first stripe is going to be. So we want to put the tape on there and then we're going to wrap our piece of paper all the way around. Until it comes all the way back to the same spot. And then we want another piece of tape. So we'll rip that. This piece of tape doesn't have to be very big.
just enough to hold that in place. Now we have our first stripe. Now we'll do our second stripe. So what we want to do is we want to kind of measure to see what's kind of like one more over. So we have another stripe here, that's another spot. And then right here where it ends, that's where we want to start our next stripe because we want there to be black, yellow, black, yellow. So we can remember where it is right here and then we'll move that over so it goes just about right there. Okay, now that we have our spot, then we can put our piece of tape on here. We'll tape him down and then we'll wrap this piece all the way around. We'll grab our second piece of tape and then we can put this guy right over the end. And now we have two stripes. Well, I guess we technically have three stripes because we've got a black, a yellow, and another black. Okay, now we want to put our last black stripe on. And so just like what I did before, it's pretty much the same thing. So this goes two more spots over. One, two. So we want to put some tape on here. So we can hold that on here. We want the black to be touching the edge. Oops, this is not going to rip. There we go. Okay. Touching the edge as best as you can. Because it doesn't have to be perfect. These don't have perfect stripes always, so we can make them how we would like them to be. Okay, then we can pull this all the way around until it covers that spot right there. And then we want our second piece of tape that off, and then put that guy on there. And that's our bee's body. It's so cute. Okay, now we want to have our wings. So my wings still, well, this part was a mistake, so that won't be on yours, but mine still has the color marker that I use, and I actually kind of like that blue color, so I'm gonna leave it. But if you don't like that, then you can use a pencil or you can decide to cut on the inside of the marker, so then you get rid of that color because it could look nice all white or it could look nice with this color, whatever color you choose. It just depends on what you think will look nice on the bee. Okay, so this is what our little fella's gonna look like. So what we want to do, we want to do a little donut thing with our tape. We're only going to do one right in the middle because we'll tape the two edges onto the bee body. But what we want to do is we want to take a piece of tape like this. We'll hold the middle with two fingers and a thumb. And we'll pull the top over under where our thumb is, lift our thumb up and put that down. We'll come to the other end that's hanging down back here. We'll pull that over, lift it over, and lift our thumb up and stick the two pieces together. Put our thumb back on there, and it'll look like a little donut, just like that. So we'll put that right in the middle, right here, because that's where the body will go. And like I said earlier, we want to use the end that has all the tape on it because then the rest of it will look nice. So we'll go ahead and put our bee on there so that piece of tape is on the middle of the body, right on the tape. And we can hold that down if we want to. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That should be fine. Okay. There's our little bee. And then we'll take one piece of tape. We'll tape the top over. We can fold it over the top. We'll take another piece of tape. We'll tape the bottom. And then we can fold it underneath like this. And then last but definitely not least, we want to put our little guy's head on. So to do that, we want to put that right about here. And we're going to use some tape. So we'll do another donut. We'll rip a piece like this. Do the same thing, two fingers with your thumb. Fold it over, lift your thumb up, put your thumb back down. Fold the other side over, lift your thumb up, put your thumb back down. And then we have a donut. So what we want to do with this donut, so we're going to put it right on to the bee body right here at the top. So I'm just going to put it right in the middle, right at the top. So it's, oops, it's touching the very top. Because the bee's head is only so big. So we wanted to the head to cover it. So now that we have that, then I'm going to put this guy with his head, the bottom of his head, so right here, I want that part to be at the bottom of the tape, so right here. So I'll go ahead and put that on right there, because we want his head to be kind of sticking up a little bit, and push down. And then we have our little bee.
So now that we have our cute little bee just in time for spring to be almost over and summer to start, we can all give him a little name, him or her, whatever name. I'll call her Buzz Buzz because she likes to buzz around. But that's all for today. And next time we're going to be doing an art and craft for the season of summer. So I can't wait to see you next time and have a nice day. Bye.